Welcome to Hello English Teacher. Today let's look at the line by line explanation of the play The Browning Version from class 11 English. If you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe. You can listen to the explanations of chapters from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. The Browning version was written by Terence Rattigan. Terence Rattigan was a British dramatist. He was one of England's most popular mid-20th century dramatists. His plays are typically set in an upper middle class background. He wrote The Winslow Boy, The Browning version, The Deep Blue Sea and Separate Tables among many others. So before moving on to the lesson, let's look at the expressions and words used in it. Remove. So here remove means the result. Kept in means grounded, that means brought to reality. Sadist is a person who gets pleasure from hurting others. Slackers are students who do not do their work. Got carried away, to get very excited or lose control of your feelings. Shriveled up, unhappy and melancholy. Muck means useless or of no practical good. Cut means to escape. So this chapter, the Browning version, is actually an excerpt from the play called the Browning version. The scene is set in a school. So there are two teachers, Frank and Crocker Harris. Frank is a young teacher, whereas Crocker Harris is a middle-aged man. And both are, as I said, both are teachers. Taplow is a young boy of 16 who has come to do some extra work for Crocker Harris. But the latter has not yet arrived. That means Crocker Harris asked him to come there and do some extra work because he was not there for the class last week. So only if he does the extra work, he is going to get his result. So that is why he has come to the school. But then when he arrives at school, he sees that Crocker Harris is not there. So he is waiting for Crocker Harris. And when he is waiting, the other teacher, that is the young teacher, Mr. Frank, comes there. And this is the first scene. So let's look at the scene. So the theme of this extract is also very beautiful. It looks into the relationship between a student and a teacher. So now let's look at the first scene. Frank. Do I know you? Taplow. No, sir. So Frank meets Taplow when he is waiting for Mr. Crocker Harris. So Frank is asking Taplow if he knows him. And Taplow says, no, I don't know who you are. What's your name? Taplow. And then Frank asks him, who is Frank? Frank is a young teacher who comes there. And so he asks him, what is his name? And immediately Taplow says that his name is Taplow. Frank, Taplow? No, I don't. You're not a scientist, I gather. So he's saying that, oh, you are Taplow. So I hope you're not a scientist. Scientist here means a science student. Okay, because he is a science teacher. So he's asking him, I hope you're not a scientist. No, sir, I'm still in the lower fifth. I can't specialize until next term. So what is he saying? No, I have not yet become a scientist. I'm still in the lower fifth grade. And I can specialize only when I get my result, that is in the next term. That's to say if I got my remove, all right. So he's saying that I can specialize, I can choose any branch only in the next term after getting my remove. Here, what is the meaning of remove? Remove here is the result. So Taplow tells Mr. Frank that he can specialize only after getting his result. Frank, don't you know if you got your remove? So immediately Frank asks, still didn't you know that whether you got your result or not? Don't you know your result till now? So Taplow says, no sir, Mr. Crocker Harris doesn't tell us the results like the other masters. So immediately the boy Taplow tells Mr. Frank that his teacher, that is Mr. Crocker Harris, is not like other teachers. Other teachers might tell the results soon, but then he is not like them. He does not tell the results earlier. Frank, why not? Well, you know what he is like, sir. So immediately Frank asks him, why is it that he is not telling? When other teachers can tell them, their students, the results, why is he not telling? Then immediately Taplow says, sir, I think you know how he is. You know how he behaves. So he will not tell us the results earlier. I believe there is a rule that form results should be announced by the headmaster on the last day of the term. And then immediately Frank says, yes, there is a rule that the results should be announced only by the principal or the headmaster on the last day of the term. And some teachers don't go by this and they just announce it to the students previously itself. But Mr. Crocker Harris is not like that. He follows all the rules and regulations. He is a strict teacher. He is a tough taskmaster, but also he does everything as per rules. So he will not say the results before like others. He is waiting for the headmaster to announce the result. Tableau, yes, but who else pays attention to it except Mr. Crocker Harris? So Tableau says, yes, it is, there is a rule like that, that only the headmasters should announce, but then other teachers do not pay any attention to it except Mr. Crocker Harris. Only he follows all the rules. Frank, I admit, but there's no criterion. So you have got to wait until tomorrow to know your fate, have you? So Frank says, yes, I agree, but I will not follow the rules. And so you have no other way, you have no other choice. So you have to wait until tomorrow till the removal, the result is announced by the headmaster. Tableau, yes, sir. Frank, supposing the answer is favorable, what then? So Frank is asking Tableau, suppose you get a favorable result, what will be your next choice? What are you going to do then? Tableau, oh yes, sign, sir, of course. So immediately Tableau says that yes, he is going to choose science. Frank, sadly, yes, we all get the slackers. So immediately Frank, who is the science teacher, says that he gets all the slackers. Who are slackers? Slackers are children who do not do any work. So immediately Tableau replies in a protesting manner. I am extremely interested in science, sir. So he says that he is not a slacker and he is actually interested in science. Frank, are you? I am not. Not at least in the science I have to teach. So immediately Frank says that, are you interested? Okay then, but I am not interested in science. Especially the science that I teach, I don't like that at all. So that is what Frank says. Tableau, well, anyway, sir, it's good deal more exciting than this muck, indicating this book. So he has a book in his hand and he is telling to Mr. Frank that science is much better than this muck. So what is muck? Useless. So he is pointing to the book and saying that that book is useless and science is more interesting than this book. What is muck? So immediately Frank asks, what are you calling as muck or useless? And Tableau says, Aeschylus, sir, the Agamemnon. So he is talking about the Greek story or the Greek tragedy called Agamemnon, written by Aeschylus. So Frank is asking, and your considered view is that the Agamemnon is muck? And so immediately Frank is asking him, so you consider this book or this tragedy or this story as useless? So Tableau answers, well, no, sir, I don't think the play is muck exactly, I suppose. In a way, it's rather good plot, really. A wife murdering her husband and all that. I only meant the way it is taught to us, just a lot of Greek words strung together and 50 lines if you get them wrong. So what is Tableau saying? He's saying that it's not the book that is muck, and he's saying it's a good plot, the theme, the story of that book or the play has a good theme. It is about a wife who is murdering the husband and all that. And he says that the way it is taught to them in the class is not good. And he's saying that a lot of Greek words are used and there are about 50 lines which you have to learn without getting anything wrong. So all these things are making it useless for him. Frank, you sound a little bitter, Tableau. So he says that you must not talk like this about great Greek literature. And you sound rather bitter, he says. Tableau, I'm rather, sir. So he says, yes, I am, because I'm not interested in learning this. So immediately Frank asks him, kept in A, that means are you grounded? That means you're tied to the spot. You're not able to move anywhere out. Tableau, no, sir, extra work. And immediately he says, no, it's not that I'm tied here. I have some extra work. I have to do some extra work. That's why I have come here. Frank, extra work on the last day of school? So Frank was surprised and he's asking, today is the last day of the school and why do you want to do some extra work today? Immediately Taplow answers, "Yes, sir, and I might be playing golf. You'd think he'd have enough to do anyway himself, considering he's leaving tomorrow for good. But oh no, I missed a day last week when I was ill. So here I am, and look at the weather, sir." And so what is Taplow saying? "Yes, today is the last day, but I have to do some work because last week I missed the class and because I was ill. So I have to come here and complete the work. Then only I will get my result. Otherwise, I would have been playing golf outside. See, look, it's a nice weather outside." So he is explaining all this to Mr. Frank. Frank, bad luck. Still, there's one comfort. You're pretty well certain to get your remove tomorrow for being a good boy in taking extra work. So immediately Frank tries to console him by telling that, okay, there is one thing you can be happy of, because tomorrow surely you're going to get your result, and you will get a good result for being a good boy because you came here to do your extra work. Taplow, well, I'm not sure, sir, that would be true of the ordinary masters, all right? So immediately Taplow says, okay, I'm not sure whether I'll get my remove tomorrow, the result tomorrow, that means a good result, because it can be, what you said can be true with other teachers, but with this man, it cannot be as we think, because he is very different from others. They wouldn't just dare not to give a chap a remove after taking his extra work. But those sort of rules don't apply to Mr. Crocker Harris. So he tries to say that other teachers may as well give a remove for this kind of work, but Mr. Crocker Harris is not like the others. I asked him yesterday outright if he had given me a remove, and do you know what he said, sir? And he says that he asked yesterday Mr. Crocker Harris about his result, and he is trying to tell Frank that he was trying to tell him what he told him when he asked him about the result. Frank, no, what? So immediately Frank says that I don't know what he told you. So what did he say? So Frank, Taplow now imitating a very gentle, rather throaty voice. So immediately Taplow started imitating Crocker Harris. So he is replying to Frank what Crocker Harris had told him yesterday by imitating Crocker Harris's voice. My dear Taplow, I have given you exactly what you deserve, no less and certainly no more. So this is what his sir, that is Mr. Crocker Harris, had told him yesterday when he had asked him about the result. So he told him that I gave you exactly what you deserve, I didn't give you anything less or anything more. So do you know, sir, I think he may have marked me down rather than up for taking extra work. And he's telling Frank also, this Mr. Crocker Harris may also give me less marks instead of giving me more marks because I did this extra work. I mean, the man's hardly human. And he's trying to tell Mr. Frank that he's hardly human. That means he's not a human being at all. He does not behave like a human. He's not a compassionate man at all. He breaks off quickly. Sorry, sir, I've gone too far. So immediately he stops imitating Mr. Crocker Harris and asks Mr. Frank sorry for imitating his colleague. And then he's asking, did I do too much? So immediately Frank says, yes, much too far. And he says that, yes, you are trying to act too much. You have imitated your teacher in such a nice manner. But then that is too much. You shouldn't be doing that. Taplow, sorry, sir, I got carried away. So he is telling that he was sorry for imitating his teacher and he was lost in his own thoughts. Frank, evidently. So Frank says, yes, it is very clear what you did. So he picks up a newspaper and opens it. Taplow, yes, sir. What was that Crocker Harris said to you? Just repeat it, would you? So he wanted to read his newspaper, but then Mr. Frank once again wanted to hear Taplow speaking just like Mr. Crocker Harris. So he's asking him to imitate his teacher once again. Taplow imitating again. My dear Taplow, I have given you exactly what you deserve, no less and certainly no more. And so immediately Taplow tries to imitate once again Mr. Crocker Harris for Mr. Frank. So he says what he had told him. Frank, looking severe, not in the least like him. Read your nice Aeschylus and be quiet. So Frank says, you don't at all sound like him at all. So you better read your book and sit there quietly. So I hope you like today's video. Let's look at the next part of this lesson in my next video. So for more informative videos, do subscribe to Hello English Teacher. Like, share and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.